deafblindness. So deafblindness is actually a rare condition in which an individual who is having a hearing and vision loss, so which can actually result in the auditory as well as the visual information. The child is not able to see as well as hearing. So deafblindness is a combination of auditory and visual information. So there are actually many causes for deafblindness. It can be due to the prematurity, it may be due to the birth complication, it can be due to any congenital syndromes. So it can be a combination of anything, and it is quite rare to see that. So deafblindness can also occur in later childhood or during the adulthood due to the cause of meningitis, brain injury, or any inherited condition. So deafblindness are mainly categorized due to this as congenital deafblindness and acquired deafblindness. So congenital is in birth, from birth onwards, and acquired is you get it on the later part of the life due to some of the other cause like aging, accident, or anything. So congenital deafblindness is the one which we train the kids from the smaller age. We teach them with the sign language, we teach them to do the braille learning. So it's a combination of both of it for their learning. Next is specific learning disabilities. So specific learning disabilities said to be a hidden disability. It is actually a child finding difficulty in many of the learning parts. Why it is said to be hidden difficulties in the beginning of the childhood or on the initial stage, we will not be able to identify. To my knowledge and with my experience, we can only identify the child with learning disabilities mainly by the age of approximately 5+, because then only the child comes up with all the factors called LSRW, which is listening, speaking, writing, and reading. So once we come into that, only we will be able to identify the learning disability. So it can be due to genetic or neurological factors that can alter the brain function in a manner which affects one or more cognitive functions which can be related to the learning. So these processing problem will actually interfere a child's skill in learning, reading, writing, or maths part. So they can also interfere in certain of the skills or higher level skills, which we call them like organization, time planning, abstract reasoning, long or short term goals, attention, etc. Like we say, a learning difficulty child to go with page number 2, page number 12, read number 4 line, para number 5, it will be very difficult for the child to understand, like to reach page number 12, then go to para number 5, then go to third line. It's a step by step process for them. So it needs to be very slow with them. Their processing is a little slow, so it takes time for them to understand the concept and come to it. So half of the things which we are expressed in Tare Sabhi Par is specific learning disability, but there are certain exemptions and cases which we have described in the film. I'm not comparing it for the film, but since you can remember what happened in a film, you'll be able to better realize it. So types of learning, there are different types of learning difficulty, which is mainly categorized as 4, which is dyscalculia, dyslexia, dysgraphia, and dyspraxia. So dyscalculia is child is finding difficulty in understanding max concept. The child finds very difficult and poor comprehension of math symbols, struggle in memorizing and organizing numbers, difficulty in telling time, finding and understanding the difficulty like concept of distance. All those max figures find that extremely difficult for the child. So dysgraphia is something that affects a person's ability, like the fine motor skills, so like illegible handwriting, inconsistent spacing, there will not be spacing between the letters, poor spatial between the papers, one line and the two line, it may overlap, So writing becomes very, very difficult for the child, and also as well as thinking and writing at the same time. The child cannot think and write. For if you have noticed, certain students find it very difficult to copy it from the board itself, because he or she has to understand what that letter is and then write it, which is ultimately a difficult thing for the child, and it takes a longer time. And next is dyslexia, which is actually a disability that affects the language-based processing. The severity can be differing from one person to another, but it can be affecting the reading fluency, decoding. Reading fluency is how speed or how we have actually kept a benchmark for each we, not as we. It's the world has actually kept a benchmark for the reading level of each child. The child of grade 1 or grade 2 will be reading this much words to this much words within the second. So the child finds very difficulty in reading fluency. The child's difficulty in blending the words, finding a difficulty in recalling. The child may not remember what exactly they have read, writing, spelling, and sometimes even speech. So dyslexia is actually referred as the language-based learning disability. So it somehow comprehends all the part of a learning. And next is dyspraxia. Dyspraxia is actually the muscle control which can cause problems in movement and coordination, language and speech, and can even affect learning. So dyspraxia is something which help find it very difficult for the coordination. It can coexist with ADHD, ADD, dyscalculia, and dyscalculia. So these are mainly a part of it. A better detail of learning disability will be coming on the later videos, as I've told you earlier. Next is hearing impairment or deafness. So a person who is not able to hear in a normal hearing, which is almost about 25 decibels is both ear, because in a smaller days I've done a test where we tap the tuning fork and keep it here, and the sound which is coming will be almost around 25 to 30 decibels. If you can't hear even that, that causes a problem in hearing. So hearing loss can be mild, moderate, severe, and profound. It can be in both the ears, it can be in one ear. So it actually affects, or it actually creates a difficulty in hearing conversational speech or loud sounds. So there are four types of hearing loss, and there are degrees of hearing losses, which actually comes on the later phase, which I'll be explaining on the upcoming classes. Next is developmental delay. Developmental delay is when your child does not reach a developmental milestone. It is actually said that by 6 months, the child laterals and sleep, and by age of 1 the child have the grip. So there is an age factor, or there is a month factor, which we basically keep a track on to see whether the child has attained the progress in a definite period of time. So developmental delay is when your child does not reach the developmental milestone in an expected time. There are certain kids who shows a developmental sign, but it's not necessary that every child who finds having developmental delay can have any issues or concern. So it's actually an ongoing major or minor delay in the process of development. So if the child is about by the age of 1 has to hold and stand, it's not necessary that the child does that. The child may do it on 2. The child gives a blabbling sound by the age of 1. There will be more of babbling sounds, but if it's not created and it's done by the age of 3, it's a developmental delay which can actually affect the speech of the child. So it can be either fine gross motor delay, or it can be even this speech delay. Next is emotional disturbance. And emotional disturbance is actually a condition in which the child exhibits many characteristics over a long period of time, to mark degree that adversely affects a child's educational performance. It literally affects the performance of the child. The child is emotionally disturbed, have an inability to learn, and cannot be explained by intellectual, sensory, or health factors. They find it unable to develop and keep appropriate or satisfactory relationship with family, peers, adults, and school system. They have a tendency to display inappropriate behavior or feeling in response to the normal situation, and they may be inclined to develop a negative physical symptoms of fear of personal or school problems. So these are the few symptoms that the emotional development students exhibit or show them. There are certain emotional specific disorders which we will be coming on the later classes. Next is the speech and language impairment. Speech is actually said when or how we say the sounds and words. So people with speech delay or the speech problems may have not say any sounds clearly, or create a horsey sound or a rapsy sound or rapsy voice, or and repeat sounds or pause when speaking, which is called as stuttering on the later phase. And language is the word which we use to share the ideas of what we want to communicate them, either in the social life or in a personal life. So a person with a language disorder may have a poor understanding, talking, reading and writing. So understanding, talking, reading and writing, a child finds very much difficulty in all of these four factors. So this is actually called as speech and language impairment. And in this speech impairment, there is many things like articulation deficiency, fluency disorder, and voice disorders. So, which we will come ahead in later. And next is traumatic brain injury. A traumatic brain injury is actually defined or said to be a blow on the head or a penetrating head injury that disrupts the formal functioning of the child. The person will not be able to lead or think or behave in a normal way like everyone else does. So a sudden traumatic brain injury to the head can suddenly and violently hit an object or on the way when any object pierces to the skull and enters the brain tissue. So basically the symptoms of a traumatic brain injury can be mild, moderate or severe depending upon how extent the damage of the brain is. So mild causes a result of brief change in the mental state or consciousness, while the severe can be due to the unconsciousness, coma, or even death.